Good morning, respected parents and my dear students. How are you all? Today we are going to study grade 5 science, block number 3 and topic number 3. Before starting our topic, I'm going to request my parents that please, parents, do not tell the answers to your child. Pause the video and ask the same question from your child. Now, so the sources which we need are the water, the stirrer. I don't have stirrer, so I will be using the spoon, the gloves, inorganic fertilizer and two balls. Please keep the resources ready so that you can do the activity nicely. Let's do a little bit revision of the previous topic. We have read about the types of crops. How many types of crops we have read yesterday? Two types? Wow, good. One is the kharif. Another one is the rabi. What is the difference between these two crops? Rabi crops are grown in winter and harvested in summer. Example, wheat. Now we are cutting the rabi crop. Crops. Okay, next. The kharif. The crops are grown in the summer and harvested in the autumn. Good. Now, I'm going to ask some questions. Now, tell me if you want to grow a plant. So, what things you need? We need a plant, sapling of a plant, or the seeds, the water, the space in the pot or in the garden. Yes. Okay, for this only we need. What else you can add to it? Have you seen the farmers throwing some things in their crops like this, the brown color or the white color? What is that? Manure. Okay, khad. Okay, wow, good. Today our topic is based on this only. So let's move towards our topic. So our topic number 3 is types of fertilizers. The aim is to differentiate between organic and inorganic fertilizer. Yani hum organic means jaivik khad aur inorganic matlab akarbanik khad ke bare mein unke padhenge ki in dono mein fark kya hai. What is the difference between them? So my question is that now tell me, why do the farmers used to add the fertilizers? For the better growth of the plants or the crops? Okay. But why to add the fertilizers? Because whenever we are growing the crops or the plants again and again on the same land, it lose their minerals. So, for adding the minerals, the fertilizer are added to the plants or the soil for the better growth of the plants. So our activity is based on this only. Okay, let's move towards our activity part. Before starting our today's activity, I'm going to tell you the amazing fact that there are three types of manure. One is a green manure, the other one is a farmyard, and the third one is a composed manure. Now let's move towards our activity. Before touching these two, please wear your gloves. Don't touch them without wearing the gloves. So as you can see, I'm having the gloves in my hands. So let's move to a decision. Inorganic fertilizer. Inorganic fertilizer वो होती हैं जो natural चीजों से नहीं बनती हैं. It's a man-made, and this is a organic one made up of cow dung. Okay. I'm having two bowls of water. I don't have stirrer. So I'm using the spoon. Please don't touch without wearing the gloves because these are not safe. They are poisonous. So what you have to do? You have to compare both of these on the basis of the texture. Ki in dono ka texture kaisa hai? Ye hard hai ya khurdari hai? Both karna hai. Fir you have to see the color. What is the color of inorganic and the organic? Then you have to see what about the if you will mix it in the water, suppose I'm going to show you.
have a look. I'm gonna pour it and just mix it. After some time it will dissolve in the water. And what about this? See, it's about to finish, but what about this? It's not. So you have to write whether they are soluble in water or not soluble in water. Are they light texture? Are they heavy or the light? Then you have to do question number 1 of page number 21 of S3. In this, this is fill in the table after observing samples of fertilizer A and B. A, we have the organic, and B, we have the inorganic. So you have to see what was the color. Let's discuss color. Iska brown tha, it's white, soluble in water. Kya ye mix hui ya nahi hui? Weight kaisa tha? Heavy lag raha hai, light lag raha hai? Odor, you have to smell it also. Smell kaisi thi isme, aa rahi thi ya nahi aa rahi thi? And the texture. Okay, texture means whether they are soft, puri pisi hui thi, ya usme granules yani danedar tha, ya kaise thi? That you have to write. Question number 1 you have to complete. Students, I'm going to show you how I have done the activity. Just have a look. The color of the sample A, dark brown, and the sample B, white. Soluble in water, yes. It doesn't solve and it's soluble. Weight is heavy and it was light, sample B. Next is a odor or the smell, means the smell was coming, yes. It has, it may not have. Texture is flaky. ये पपड़ी दार था, इसमें पपड़ियाँ थी. And it's granular. इसमें ये दानेदार था. Sample A was of organic and sample B inorganic.
I hope you all have done the activity. So let's move towards our questioning part. Before that, what is left? Amazing fact. Okay, yes. In Arabic language, banana, केले का जो meaning, banana word का जो meaning होता है, वो क्या होता है? Fingers.
So my first question is, how is sample A is different from sample B? So here is a table that shows the difference between sample A and B. Color of sample A was dark brown, sample B white. सॉल्युबिलिटी इन वाटर, सैम्पल ए पानी में नहीं घुल पा रहा था, सैम्पल बी हाँ घुल पा रहा था. हैवी एंड लाइट, भारी और हल्के में, सैम्पल ए वॉज हैवी, सैम्पल बी वॉज लाइट. टेक्स्चर, सैम्पल ए फ्लैकी था, मीन्स वो पपड़ी वाला था, उसमें पपड़ी आई हुई थी. सैम्पल बी ग्रैनुला, मीन्स वो दानेदार था. नेक्स्ट इज आउटर और द स्मेल, सैम्पल ए में थी स्मेल एंड सैम्पल बी में हो भी सकती है. द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज, हाउ डज वी गेट दीज फर्टिलाइजर्स? फर्टिलाइजर ए इज मैन्योर ऑब्टेन्ड बाय डिकम्पोजिशन ऑफ डेड ऑर्गेनिक मैटर लाइक वेजिटेबल पील्स, डेड लीव्स, एक्सक्रीटा ऑफ एनिमल्स एटसेट्रा, मीन्स वेस्ट ऑफ एनिमल्स. Fertilizer B is made from chemicals in factories and is said to be inorganic. Just have a look. It's a manure, organic fertilizer. This is inorganic fertilizer. The next question is, which of the above is easy to transport and used by farmers? Why? Inorganic fertilizer is easy to transport and used by farmer because it is light in weight and increases the production of crops in less time. How is solubility of fertilizer in water useful? If a fertilizer is soluble in water, it dissolves in water and the roots of plants can take in the minerals along with the water. What are the qualities of a good fertilizer? A good fertilizer should be light in weight, easy to transport, should provide all nutrients to the soil, should be required in small amount, should be fast to act, and most important, should not harm the crops or the soil. What is the main disadvantage of using inorganic fertilizers? The main disadvantage of using inorganic fertilizers is that they cause harm to the soil and they do not decompose. The next question is, how is inorganic fertilizer different from organic fertilizer? Inorganic fertilizer, they are usually made in factory. Small amount of them make soil fertile in less time. Organic fertilizer, made from decomposed plant and animal waste, slow action, large quantity. How would the amount or the yield of crops affected if farmers did not use inorganic fertilizer? Why? Inorganic fertilizer act fast and help the crops to grow fast and be healthy. The yield would be less as the crops would not get minerals. So the next question is, which type of fertilizer is better? Why? Both organic and inorganic have their own advantages and disadvantages. Manure provides all nutrients to the soil, is slow to act but does not pollute the soil, is difficult to transport and use. Inorganic fertilizer provide only specific nutrients to the soil, are soluble in water so act fast, are easy to transport and use, are required in small amount but pollute the soil. And the next question is, tell the ways of making manure at home. I wrote two ways. First is, keep over ripened fruits and vegetables, nuts and eggshells in a pit. Sprinkle some wood ash to boost the composting process. And the second one is, add the prepared kitchen waste to the garden compost bin. Students, please read page number 16, the heading organic and inorganic fertilizers from the content book. Then you have to complete S3 of page number 21 in workbook. Question number 1 we have done. The question number 2 is, how is an inorganic fertilizer different from an organic fertilizer? Okay, next question is, how would the amount yield of crops be affected if farmer did not use inorganic fertilizer? Why? And the B is, how does use of inorganic fertilizer affect the environment? Okay. Homework for today is that you have to do question number 5 and 6 of page number 18 in the notebook. Question number 5 is, what are the qualities of a good fertilizer? And question number 6 is, what is the main disadvantage of using inorganic fertilizers?
Let's sum up what we have done today. Today we have read about the fertilizer, the difference between the two fertilizers, that is organic and inorganic. Organic are dark brown, inorganic white in color. Organic, not soluble in water, mix nahi hote paani mein. Inorganic, soluble in water. Organic, heavy, bhari hote hain. Inorganic, light. Organic, flaky matlab papdi dar hote hain, unke andar papdi aa jati hai jab. And inorganic, granular, yani danedar hoti hai ye. Before saying bye, there is one more amazing fact, that is, an average tree can provide us so much wood that we can make near about 170,100 pencils. यानी 170,100 हम पेंसिल बना सकते हैं, वो उतनी हमें वुड प्रोवाइड करता है. थैंक यू एंड हैव अ नाइस डे.